Are you using setState correctly? Or have you noticed how many times your build method gets called? If not, then watch out this video where I'll be talking about provider implementation and the common mistake I was doing with setState. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. This is your host Afzal, and today I'm going to talk about provider. Before we actually begin with the provider concept, I want to tell you the mistake that I have done initially as a beginner in Flutter platform. So what I used to do that I used to apply setState everywhere possible, and that is what people are doing out there because they have been told that setState is the way to update the UI. So I'm going to show you how to do this in a proper way with the help of a provider. But before that, we will demonstrate this with the help of this OTP page or timer page, and we will also cover the theory part of provider. So stay tuned till the end of the video where we are going to discuss and talk about provider a lot. So let's get started without any delay. So here you can see that I have a simple page. So because it's an advanced level tutorial, I'm not going to talk about the basics. It's a very simple page. It has three widgets like this, and that is placed over here. And it has an initial value of 60 with some style that I'm showing over here, right? And that is being called from the My App. Now what I want, this timer should decrement by one number after each second. So how are we gonna do that? Just a real quick for the demonstration purpose. So I'm going to override init method. Inside int state, I will implement a timer periodic with the duration of 1 second. For the callback, I'm going to write the logic to decrement the value. So here we'll say initial value minus minus, and here we have it. Something I missed, I think, yeah, the instance of a timer as a parameter it returns, and we are good to go. Let's just hot reload. Nothing happens. Why? Because we are not setting the state. This doesn't know that we have to update the UI. So let's just wrap this real quick inside a set state method that we used to do earlier. I'll just move this up like this and just format it. And the OTP page, the timer page, is ready in just few lines of code. But what is the issue with that? That it's rendering the entire page each second. Just for proof of concept, I'll write a print command here. And let's just restart it. So here you can see in the log, let me just clear it. Every second, it's starting from the scratch. The image is redrawn. The size box is redrawn and the value is redrawn. We don't want that. So you will say, what is the issue with that? Let the Flutter engine rebuild entire page. But for this kind of a simple page, it is fine. But what about if you have a page like this, where you have the timer deep down in the widget tree? It will cost you in the terms of performance if you apply this kind of set state in this type of application. Here also you can see the timer is deep down inside the widget tree. Not only just about the timer thing or decrement counter or something, anywhere where you have to update the part of UI. You don't want to repaint other things just because you want to update some of the value. I'm going to fire Adobe XD real quick. I have drawn a presentation so that you can grasp it. And let me just hide it. So in provider concept, we have three important parts. One is the change notifier provider, which creates the instance of your data. This change notifier provider will hold the instance of that. Second thing, from anywhere inside your page, if you want to update the value, you just get the instance of that provider and you can manipulate the value. As soon as the value is changed, it will notify all the consumers. Once the consumer gets data, you can update your widget accordingly without affecting any of this hierarchy. So that is the whole theory about it. It may sound difficult when we are discussing, but the implementation is very easy. Let me show you how. The first thing which we will need to implement provider is the provider package itself. So let's go ahead to pubspec YAML file and add the dependency for provider. I'm going to say any version. So our package is loaded. Now we have to start implementing provider in our application. What we will need in the first place is the model which will hold the data. So I'm going to create timer info dot dart, and here I'm going to declare a class called timer info, and will also declare one field which will hold remaining time. Let's create a getter setter real quick, and for that I'll say get remaining time, which will return me the value. And for the update, I'm going to say update remaining time. And now we have to call notify listener from here. To do that, we'll have to extend our class. This is the important part, that we have to extend our class with change notifier, which is there in the foundation package. So that is the important part. Then you can say whenever there's an update in the value of remaining time, you can say notify listeners. So that is the point number two, the part of the point number two, basically, that we have the model ready and it notifies all the listener. Now we have to create the instance of the model, which is the first step of our provider implementation. Let's go ahead and create the instance of this timer info inside our page. We have to ask one question to ourselves, where we need this instance. So in our example, we need this instance inside this init state method from where we are going to update the value. So we want the information at this page level. If you want somewhere inside the column on a click of a button, so you have to create a change notifier at that level. We don't have to pollute the scope as per the documentation. We have to create it where we need it. We need in the page level, so we are going to create it here in the home page. We are not going to create at the top on the material app because we are not going to change anything inside the theme or title depending on that data. We are going to change only this home page. So what I'll do, I'll just wrap this with a widget called change notifier provider. Let me just resolve it. And here we have it. This change notifier provider has a child property which takes our page. And now we are going to create the instance of timer info using the create property. It gives us context if you want to initialize something based on the context, but we are not going to use it. We'll just say timer info and our object is ready. So this object we can ask anytime in this hierarchy inside homepage from any place. We can just say that give me the instance of timer info and the data will be available to you. Entire instance will be available. So let's go ahead in the homepage and ask for this instance. I want to create a variable which will hold this timer info, and from where this data will come? From the provider. Provider.of context. And what type of data we want, that we have to specify so that provider will look for the exact instance. At this point, we have the timer info instance with us. Now we can get the data, we can update it, we can play around with that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to update the remaining time from here each second. So now let's comment this out. We don't want this set state to call. We are going to update it from here each second. And I think we don't even need this one. Fine. So now we have covered two steps. First step, that we created the instance of our timer info. We created the timer info itself and we created the instance of it. And the second part, that we updated the value somewhere from the page. Now we are in the third step where we have to consume this data provided by the provider. So let's go ahead and wrap this text widget. Because we want this data inside a text widget, we are not going to pollute the scope again. We don't have to place somewhere on the scaffold or the column. We want this updated data inside a text. We will keep it limited to the scope. And let's just wrap this text with the consumer real quick. And the important point here again, that this consumer should know what type of data I'm going to consume. Otherwise, it will give just a dynamic value. Maybe you can cast it later, but that will create some complexity. So what we can do is we can define what type of data we need. So I want timer info from this consumer. That's fine. And this consumer has a builder property. Oh, spelling mistake, sorry. So now we have the builder method. This builder method gives us three parameters: context, the actual data, and the child property. We are not going to look into the third property as of now. So let's just say quickly, context is the first parameter that it gives. Second is the data, and third one is the child. Now it's not giving the error. We're good. For this example, I want this text widget like this. And we are going to remove this child tag. Let's save it and see how it looks. All good. Now instead of using the initial value, I'm going to say data dot get remaining time. Perfect. Now we don't need this variable out here. Let's delete it. And all good. Let's just run the application and see real quick how it's going to look like. Now our application is running, but you can see that data is not getting updated. The reason we are getting the instance of timer info outside the visual tree. For that, we can specify this listen flag to false, which will not listen for the callback. And then if we restart it, and it's working as expected. That is what we wanted, right? If you are getting the instance of a timer inside your visual tree, you can leave at this point. If you are calling it from somewhere outside the visual tree, then you have to say listen false. That is the important point that I wanted to mention. That's why I have created a scenario like this. Now I'm going to check the debug console how many times this widget tree is getting rendered. So let's restart the application one more time. Here you can see that it says started from scratch only once, and it's changing the value. So that is what we wanted to achieve. It's not repeating, it's not rendering the image assets again and again each second. It's not rendering the size box. And because this is a simple example, you may think that this is a very minor thing. But if you have a complex example, as I said earlier, like this and this, this really makes a difference and your application will perform much better. So hope you understand the whole concept. And thank you so much for watching. Subscribe the channel for more such content. I'll be creating more such videos about provider, about chain notify provider, multi providers, Flutter fundamental concepts, widget trees, visual components, UI design, a lot of topics we will cover inside Flutter. So stay tuned, subscribe the channel if you haven't already, like the video, give it a thumbs up. It really helps me a lot, and see you guys in the next one.